I feel that too.
Just like, I just want to show the race everything before, and it's like, let's have some
right.
private time.
So what is everybody's pit strategies on this?
Survive.
The plan, the plan for me, give or take, is 8-8 and then 7-7-7. But I'm open to an 8-7-8-7-7.
Yeah, just 2-8 somewhere.
Yeah, but I mean, on the 8, you've got to literally fucking...
You have to feel safe like a man.
Yeah.
As well as have good slipstream.
Yeah, if you don't have slipstream, you don't. Just do 7 laps. That's what it looks like.
Good lap, Paladin. Great lap. Eighth place? Man, I thought that was a good lap. Like, 300s divide the top 8. What happened to Storm?
Arson.
Shit lap. Anyway. Shit lap.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Good luck, boys.
Good luck.
Good luck, guys. Yeah, good luck.
Yeah, good luck. Keep it clean. Here are the differences. Man, 8th, 9th place? Sheesh. Or 8th place. Okay. now this extreme black rebel in a lap 6, which I find very, very interesting. I'm gonna need to continue to do a bit of fuel saving. Fuel in this stint. Interesting. It's definitely cutting it. Oh, it should be okay. Okay, so coming in with one fuel, doing a 1 8 lap stint. And even if I do another 1 lap stint, another 8 lap stint, that's good because I'm going to be coming behind Greg, who's and then 7 laps in, so he still has 2 8 laps things to go. I gave Greg enough space there. Not looking to burst any laps or pressurized attacks into Greg right now, because I know what he has to do later on, and that's when I can attack. I can force him into a bit of a mistake, and I felt like that was a bit harsh on my end, his POV. This is good. I'm quite happy with this. I hope on his POV it doesn't look too bad. That's okay. Bit of a risk, yeah, it's not worth it. He has the inside line. Oh, I forced him into a mistake. Good. That's good, that's positive. And I have 29, 22 laps, that's good. Interesting, Black Rebel, is he going for like an extra stint or something like that? I don't know if I'm gonna make it on this stint. I don't think I will. I'm taking a big risk. Okay, let's go for it. this is squeaky bum time. I might lose too much time saving fuel. Maybe I'll be okay. Four. No, I should be okay. Because we qualified in eight, that allows me to hit in a little bit earlier. 96 should be enough. I'm okay with this. So now it's seven lap stints all the way. And push, push, push. Boogity, boogity, boogity. It's gonna be difficult. Okay, I'll take advantage of that. Thank you very much. Now I've got to be careful, Black Rebel. Very good driver. I think his fuel stints are a little bit weird, I want to say. Oh, what? Okay, don't know what happened there, but... Huh. Can I catch up to Darcy? This is now the big question. Not in slipstream, that's a bit of a blur. But I do have 57 fuel for 3 laps, so it gives me good scope to push. Brake hard, turn in sharp, still carry the speed. Hit the apexes, I want to make sure I don't get any CC points. Wide there, but again, no CCD, which I'm a little bit happier about. Texas hits fastest lap. He's probably going to increase lead in the overall standings from me, which is little bit of a shame, and with the likes of Paladin, who I got ahead in the overall standings, he's looking to finish pretty good. So don't know what happened to Greg as well, because he's in eighth, I think. No, let's not worry about those. Let's worry about what's going on ahead and what I can do to catch up with Darcy. And I believe Texas. Paladin looking good in first place. Fair play to him. He deserves a win. He really deserves a win. I could pull out a risky six up, but I don't think it's worth it. Now, Darcy Loki doing that? Ah, interesting. So, yeah, Darcy and someone else doing that. Seven fuel, so I can come out with 96. I have good scope to push, but I don't really want to go any less than 96. 96 exactly. Yeah, so Darcy got ahead of Texas on that, which is positive because I think it's gonna force Darcy into undercut, therefore fuel saving, or longer stint there for fuel saving, and then therefore slowing him and Texas down. But again, I'm not in slipstream, so Greg lost connection. I just had a peek over at Discord on my other monitor. Said he lost connection. That's what happened to him. Shame. So Texas has gone past Darson, which I think is low-key intentional, because Darson has to do a longer stint. I just don't think I can catch up. These guys are too decent on the pace and I'm not pulling in quick enough laps. I don't think they're pulling ahead per se, but I'm not catching up, and zero CCDs for me is certainly not a bad thing so far. What feels like a very professional race for me, if I do say so myself. Two laps. Curious to see what lap Darson pits on. It's lap 29. And that would be twice as interesting. Nobody really around me. There's no point in me pulling in now, of course. Could be the case of Darson, case of Paladin. Oh, Paladin's coming in now, but that's his last stint. That's how far ahead he is of me. Fucking hell. Anything, but one thing I can hope for is that Darson hasn't got Texas's slipstream and therefore I can potentially catch up to him. But I think he just about has gotten Texas's slipstream. It would require a big, big miracle for me to get up to 5th. Oh, Black Rebel, you could have swung ahead of me and give me a little bit of an old slipstream there, son. place on Timmerzz, but alone on the first dude.
Oh man. What a
night
race. Very
nice
race.
I kinda kept an eye on the cluster when you said it in the corner of my eye, like.
What position are you?
Sixth. Honestly, I'm not disappointed with that. When you really think about it, like, it was so close in qualifying, like, so close. What? 3/10 dividing the top 8? That's like very, very close.
Yeah. It was